no reason to be together. Nothing else brings us together except La ilaha illallah, except Muhammadur Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Wa akharina minhum lamma yalhaqu bihim. And so after he says this, this is a favor of Allah. This is not something small. ذَلِكَ فَضْلُ اللَّهِ يُؤْتِيهِ مَنْ يَشَاءُ. That's the favor of Allah. He gives it to whoever He wants. وَاللَّهُ ذُو الْفَضْلِ الْعَظِيمِ. Allah is the possessor of the ultimate favor. The ultimate favor that this book should not be reduced to that desert. This book should ripple, and its message should ripple, and it should shake the entire world. It should go every nook and cranny in the world, so that we can repeat and recite what the Messenger was given, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This is the first passage of this surah. Surah Al-Jumu'ah is about what the Messenger started with and where it went all over the world. Where it is meant to go all over the world. That's the first passage. The second passage is actually a completely different subject. The Jewish community and their failure with their book. مَثَلُ الَّذِينَ حُمِّلُوا التَّوْرَاةَ ثُمَّ لَمْ يَحْمِلُوهَا كَمَثَلِ الْحِمَارِ يَحْمِلُوا أَسْفَارًا. The example of those who were loaded on with the responsibility of the Torah, the previous revelation, the book given to Musa. And they didn't carry it. They didn't carry that responsibility. Their example is like mules, donkeys. يَحْمِلُوا أَسْفَارًا. That is carrying loads and volumes of books. They're just carrying volumes. What does that mean? This is not a scathing criticism of the Jewish community. It's an example of those who have been given revelation, but they don't ponder upon that revelation. They don't recite it onto the people in the previous ayat. They don't recite it onto the people that like their messenger used to. They don't purify themselves and each other by the word of Allah like their messenger used to. They don't teach the book. They don't teach its meaning and its laws and its injunctions like their messenger used to. They don't try to internalize its wisdom like their messenger used to. When they forget about these roles that the book was supposed to play, then this is nothing but a mule carrying books. If the Quran was reduced, like they reduced the Torah, if the Quran was reduced just to something to recite and you don't even think about it, you just memorize certain words and you chant them and you don't even know what you're saying. That's all the Quran is. If the Quran is the only thing it is a security for your car so you keep it in your dashboard so you don't get into an accident. Or you can hang it, the Ayatul Kursi, in your rear view mirror or something. Because you don't have dual side airbags. You know? If that's what Quran has become to you. If the only value of Quran is to recite a little bit of it before the wedding ceremony, and that's it, that's all the Quran will ever need. Or only open it up when somebody passes away or something. If that's what's happened, then this is nothing but mules carrying a load. This is not why the book was sent. It was sent, يَتْلُوا عَلَيْهِمْ آيَاتِهِ وَيُزَكِّيهِمْ وَيُعَلِّمُهُمُ الْكِتَابِ وَالْحِكْمَةِ. That's why it was sent. Don't do with your book what the people before you have done with their book. This is what Allah is saying in these ayat. And then something happens, something remarkable in the Quran. Allah makes connections, you and I could never have made them. Allah puts things together. You know, this kalam is hakim, and one of the meanings of hakim is actually muhkam, things that are tied to each other, woven into each other, put together. We could not have put it together like this. What is the subject that Allah put together with it? He says, قُلْ يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ هَادُوا إِنْ زَعَمْتُمْ أَنَّكُمْ أَوْلِيَاءُ لِلَّهِ مِنْ دُونِ النَّاسِ فَتَمَنَّوا الْمَوْتِ إِنْ كُنْتُمْ صَادِقِينَ. And then later on, إِنَّ الْمَوْتَ الَّذِي تَفِرُّونَ مِنْهُ فَإِنَّهُ مُلَاقِيكُمْ. Tell these people that have been Jews, tell them those that have done wrong with their book, that if you think that you're friends with Allah, as opposed to all other people, you're more special than everybody else, then why don't you wish for death? And they will never wish for death. And tell them the death that you're running away from. الموت الذي تفرون منه. The death that you are running away from. فَإِنَّهُ مُلَاقِيكُمْ. It is going to meet you no matter what you do. It is as good as already met you. ثُمَّ تُرَدُّونَ إِلَىٰ عَالِمِ الْغَيْبِ وَالشَّهَادَةِ. Then you will be taken back to the one who knows the unseen and the seen. The knower of the unseen and the seen. فَيُنَبِّئُكُمْ بِمَا كُنْتُمْ تَعْمَلُونَ. Then he will tell you what you used to do. What does all of this have to do with Jumu'ah? The first subject was how the message will spread all over the world. The second subject was how the people before us, the Jewish nation, they didn't do right by their book, and they became obsessed with this life to the point where they want to run away from death. And the third subject is the Jumu'ah prayer. You know why that's important? It's important because the Prophet ﷺ, his entire mission to describe the perfection of Allah through reciting the ayat of Allah, by purifying people's minds and their hearts, by teaching them what Allah says in His book, the law that Allah has revealed, the wisdom that Allah has revealed. That process is actually carried out as a community every single Friday prayer. We fulfill the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, حينما نتلو على أنفسنا آياته. When we recite the word of Allah, يُزَكِّيهِمْ وَيُعَلِّمُهُمُ الْكِتَابُ وَالْحِكْمَةِ, this is how we relive the mission of the Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Allah put this in place, this program that you and I come to every Friday. You don't have to be emailed about what time you have to be here. You don't have to see a Facebook post what time the event comes. There's no flyers for Jumu'ah prayer. We just show up every single time, on our own, unadvertised. The old and the young.